when our country was a lusty, sprawling young baby. After a hard day's work in the field, a man had come home to a cabin he'd built himself. His wife would serve him a hot supper, corn pone, greens, and maybe a piece of fried meat from his own smokehouse. After supper, he'd take out his battered old fiddle and pour his contentment, his dreams, and all his future plans into the squeaky old box. When he did, a miracle happened. A new kind of music was born. America's very own music, country music. From that day until this, country music has been the heart, soul, and voice of her people. Listen. You'll hear a pioneer beside a campfire, fiddling up his courage, keeping a sharp lookout for the dangers of the night. Or a black man pouring his disappointments and blues into a harmonica as he takes a break from levee toil. Or a Texan smitten by the soulful eyes of a beautiful senorita just across the border, trying hard to make his calloused fingers play the haunting music of her native land on his beat-up old guitar. Our prisoner, picking out his dreams of freedom, trying to reach outside the bars that confine him. Our lonely wanderer, riding the rails, singing softly of home, with a girl he left behind riding easy on his mind. Our Sunday group of folks with hymn books in hand, singing simple songs of praise, saying, "Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful land you've given us." Yes, America's own music is like the great melting pot of America herself. There's a little bit of every one of us in 200 years of country music.